Hi, welcome to How to Repair. This video is showing you the back-end administration system on our solar-powered shop and apartments, showing you how we became environmentally friendly. So here we are at our monitoring system for our shop and two apartments. The graph will show you all the power that is produced on a daily basis. We have 12.6 kilowatt of batteries and 5 kilowatt of solar panels. This is expandable to roughly 10 kilowatt of solar panels and 25 kilowatt of batteries, but we don't require it. We've built our system for only what we need. So here you can see the different days and you can see how much power we were producing. The orange is the solar, the green is the consumption, and if it goes below the line, that is when we are pulling power off the grid. Now on this day we were pulling power 3.5 kilowatt, and then the solar array started to shut down. This is because our battery banks were full and we have our system set not to export energy to the grid, which is one of the requirements over here in Portugal. And basically we started charging the system at 7 o'clock in the morning, and we were running all day until about 12, 1 o'clock, and then the system shut down. Now this day you can see we've got very bad weather and we managed to deplete our battery bank. So you can see the solar was low on that day. The green is the consumption, but you can see where our battery banks run out, and we went red below the line, which means we are pulling electricity off the local supplier. The next day the sun came up and we started charging the batteries, but it was still a poor day. But we managed to go through until early hours of the morning before we had to pull off the grid. Now let's have a look at our battery system. The dark green is the battery capacity, which you can see rising here. The orange is showing you when the PV power was available, and at about 11, 12 o'clock we actually got up to what we call float capacity on the lithium ion batteries, which is about 94-95%. And as you can see, when it started to decline, that's when the sun had set and the power was being drawn off the batteries. And you can see here on a really bad day that the sun was not very good and we were discharging all day. And this means that we took our battery bank down to the minimum level, which we've got set at 10%. But the next morning we managed to bring the batteries up to about 50%, although it was still a bad day and overcast. But I imagine by the end of the day we will be up to about 85 to 90%, which will be enough to allow us to have 10, 11 kilowatts of storage capacity running us through to the next day. Now let's have a look at the real-time graph. This is basically showing us what is happening at the moment. We've got 1500 watts of power going into the inverter, where 782 is going to the batteries at the moment, and as you can see we're at 64%. The house is the house symbol down below. This means the property is drawing 600 odd watts of power. And the grid power that's showing there, although we are sending some power to the grid, this is to keep the phases balanced so it understands what the electricity supply coming into the building is. We've got ours set at zero, which means we're not exporting to the grid, but it will always stay tied to the grid. This is due to the inverter needing to know the grid voltage and frequency and always stay in sync with the grid. Here is the system installed in the shop. We've normally got it behind glass panels, but I took them off for photographing. And the panel array with our water systems on the roof. You can find more information at the website with regards to all the solar tutorials and installations and products and solutions that we do. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you very much for watching.